Voluptuously Skinny, and I am here with my post-op week 87 update. My highest weight was 369.9. My surgery weight was 329.6. I had the gastric sleeve done on September 16th, 2015. My current weight now is 161.4, which means that I am up 2 pounds from my lowest weight of 159.4. And that's 2 pounds up from last week. And then I am 7.7 away from my mini goal of 153.7, which puts me in the normal category. And then total, that's still 208.5 pounds gone. So I'm doing great in that area. As far as calories are concerned, my total calories average was 1583 last week. And that was a lowest day of total calorie was 651. And my highest was 2,144. And then as far as net calories are concerned, my average was 1,029, the lowest being 28 nets for one day, and the highest being 1,780. As far as protein is concerned, on average, I got in 80 grams per day last week. And as far as carbs were concerned, y'all remember I got my cake. So as far as the carbs were concerned, I had, my carbs were 206 on average per day. So as far as exercise is concerned, y'all know I ran my half marathon last week and I exercised 4 times. I did 4 runs. And as far as calorie burn, the lowest amount of calories that I burned for an exercise was 493, and then the highest was over 1700 calories, and that was when I ran the half marathon. And so that was my calorie burn. My gain, I find that typically after a long run, sometimes I will get a little, I don't know if like my muscles are inflamed or I start to try and hold on to a little bit of water, so that may be kind of where that's from. Not quite sure. As far as food, I am trying out some new energy bars because, like I told you guys last week, my nutritionist told me to get in more calories. Ugh. She said to get in more calories, and so that is what I am on a mission to do so that it matches the amount of exercise that I'm doing and it matches what my body needs in order to continue to function properly. As far as challenges, that's one of the challenges, is eating more, and I want to eat more without resorting to a bunch of junk food. And that's what I'm doing on some of the extras. When I get ready for a race, I don't mind so much because I truly am carb loading. But even then, when I'm carb loading, I try to like the Lenny's and Larry's cookies, those are great for carb loading for me. And then I do try to eat stuff like, I will eat more bread during those times. I don't really eat a lot of pasta anymore, and so I probably could try to use that. I didn't even think about that till just now. So I could try to eat some more pasta. Rice, I could try to eat that. I think I made egg rolls, and so that those had some carbs in it. And then fruit, I do eat a fruit for carbs. And so the other thing as far as trying to get in calories, I have taken to eating, I eat almonds anyway, but like when I go to my grandmother's house, I'll grab peanuts. But the bottom line is my stomach can only hold so much. And when I get full, I am full. So I really just don't want anything else. But peanuts, avocados, energy bars, anything like that. If you guys have had, if some of you have had weight loss surgery and you're now like a half marathon or marathon runner, or you exercise like a lot, and you're burning a lot of calories, tell me what you do in order to keep your the amount you eat at the right What do you do? What are you doing? I know that my nutritionist said it is something that's very new and on the forefront of everything, and they are even going to conferences that are brand new where they're speaking because they know even a lot more than what other people know as far as exercising. But I know that there are some of us lay people who may not even see a nutritionist or a surgeon or doctor or what have you, but they've just figured it out on their own. And so if you have figured that out on your own, let me know what you're doing. Because I am struggling with that a little bit, because when I do get in more calories on those particular days, it's because I have eaten like some candy or something like that. And I just know that that could be a slippery slope, and I don't want to get to a point where I'm either craving that, or if I'm unable to exercise, that I can't stop eating that and I end up gaining weight. So, as far as non-scale victories, you guys, half marathon, of course. I am getting ready to be in half a half fanatic soon. I am getting ready to run another half marathon. So, in order to be a half fanatic, you have to run a marathon, or excuse me, two halves. Or they also have marathon maniacs, but half fanatic, you have to run two half marathons within 16 days of each other, or three in 90 days, and I think, or maybe six or seven throughout the year, something like that. So I'm doing two within 16 days. So I'm getting ready to take a little mini vacation with my sister Dion and my niece. And we're going to go to Kansas City. So if any of you are in Kansas City, hit me up, email me at voluptuouslyskinny at gmail.com, or hit me on Instagram at voluptuouslyskinny, or comment on here. I'm getting ready to go through all my comments today and answer them. And let me know if you are in Kansas City, Missouri, excuse me, Kansas City, Missouri. And especially if you're going to be at the Hospital Hill Run, because that is the run that I am running. So I'm excited about that. And I will actually run the 5K on Friday and then the half marathon on the next day on Saturday, because I wanted to get the rerun medal. So anyway, the other thing, I talked about my body being at 21% body fat, and I'm still just astounded by that. I am just truly still impressed by that. And sometimes I still can't really see it. I can kind of see it, but then I see my skin, and I do see now that my skin is a lot of loose skin. It used to be more where it looked really fatty, but now it's starting to really just look like loose skin. So I see that, but still just astounded by that. And then I'm gonna go ahead and close, because I'm not gonna keep you guys too long. But I'm gonna close, and I want to say this. I did get a message from a young lady on Instagram, and when she was writing me, she said that she was struggling a bit, and I think she was quite a bit further out and was just trying to get some tips and advice on how to get back in the game, get back on track. And one of the things that she started with was, "You make this seem so easy." And I thought to myself, you know what? I probably do, because I really speak a lot about the positive stuff and not so much about, especially now that I'm further out, not so much about the things that I really deal with. And when I tell you, there are things that I deal with that I don't talk about, there are things that I deal with that I do talk about. And I say there are demons, there is depression, there is discouragement, there are so many things that I feel. But when I come to you guys, I talk to you guys in a way that really is me talking to myself. It's me putting positive things into the atmosphere. It's me trying to make those positive things become law. Because God said that if we speak it, that, you know, and we believe it, that we shall receive it. And so those are the things that I really am trying to speak into existence, because I do deal with my own set of demons. I do deal with depression. I do deal with being discouraged sometimes. There are times where recently, especially, that I get on the scale, and because I just want to see that 153, and I really don't have to, but I just want to. And so there have been a few times where I've gotten on the scale and then got off of it and got back on it. And I have to catch myself and say, Kanita, chill out. You know, it's not about that. Get yourself together, girl. Don't get so obsessed with that, that it makes you crazy. And so, you know, I have to talk myself down from the cliff sometimes. I really do. Pastor, on this past Sunday, he was talking about limited thinking and how it limits when we don't look in our word, and when we don't look in it daily, that it doesn't allow us to renew our mind. And he based it off of the Romans 12, 1 through 2, I believe it was the scripture. And he talked about seven different things that help us renew our mind and to stay on course and to stay on track. And there are three things that were in there that really hit me, and that was preparation, patience, and persistence. And those things to me are key when we're trying to make sure that we are being successful with this weight loss journey, getting rid of this weight, with this, just, it's a renewal of the mind. It is a daily renewal of the mind. And that is when I speak these things, or when I talk about the positive, basically what I'm trying to do is renew my mind, because like I said, there are things that go through my mind every day that I just, sometimes I talk about a lot of it. Trust me, I do talk about a lot of it there, but there are day-to-day things that sometimes I'm going through that by the time I'm making a video that I forget to talk about, but that doesn't mean that I'm not dealing with them. And so I by no means ever want to make this seem like it is easy, because it's not. It is not. But like I said, it is a daily renewal of the mind. It's about being preparing for what it is that we need to prepare for, preparing daily. Like when I know that I'm going to get up and run, because there are days, I'm going to tell you, there are days that I don't want to run. But the night before, I've put out my shoes, I've put out my heart monitor, I've put out my waistband, my pouch, I've put out my clothes, my socks. And so that way, when I roll out of bed, I know I can look over there and I can see my things, and I know it is time to get up and do it. And I always say, there's a lot of times that I'll write on my run keeper at the end that the finish always feels so much better than the start. And that is so true. When I finish a run, when I finish a good walk, I feel so amazing and so accomplished. So preparation is huge. And then just being patient. Patience is so key. You guys, we did not gain this weight overnight. And I know you've heard that said a million times. We didn't gain the weight overnight. So we can't lose it overnight. We didn't gain the skills. You know, we don't, when we're learning how to run, or when we're learning how to walk again, or when we're learning how to get back into different activities, we have to start slow, and we have to be patient with ourselves and know that it's going to take time in order to get to the point where we want to be, especially when we're looking at other people's accomplishments. And yes, you're not supposed to compare yourself to other people, but I look at other people for inspiration, and I strive to be where they are, and not only where they are, but I strive to be even better. I was praying for a sorority sister the other day, and you know, she was just saying, you know, thank you so much. And I told her that that I see, when I see other people's healing, that it allows me to have a deeper faith and a deeper belief in my own healing. And so it helps me to see others' healing manifest. It just helps me know that my healing is coming too. Because I feel like, and Pastor says it all the time, if God can do it for others, he will do it for you too, and even greater things than these. So I just strive. So it takes patience. It takes patience in order to be able to get to that point. So just be patient. And trust me, I learn patience and it tries me every single day. It tries me when I'm dealing with my breast issue. It tries me when I'm dealing with Dion. It tries me when I'm dealing with other people. When I'm driving down the street, I have to pray on that every day. When I'm dealing with my weight, when I step on that scale and it's still, you know, the same as it was last week or it's up, I have to know that my body is adjusting and it's going to take patience. It's been a long time coming and I'm not going to ever mess anything up because of a few weeks in this whole, in the whole scheme of things. So even when you're on a stall, just have patience. Think about, you know, if you've been a year out and then all of a sudden you get this stall and you've had the stall for 6 weeks and you just want to blow it. So you're going to blow the other 46 weeks for the one set of 6 weeks where you're stalling. Don't do that. Just have patience. And then persistence. Make sure that you're continuing to go. Make sure that you're continuing. I say continuing to go forward and how you're conducting yourself as far as your lifestyle change, as far as your eating habits, as far as whatever activity you have decided to do. Just be persistent with it. Continue to do it. Be diligent about it. That was one of the things I told my therapist, you know, with the running. I said, I go to the running because it is something that I know that I can control and I can control what my body is doing. And so that allows me to continue to be persistent every single day. And that persistence allows me to get better and better. It allows me to continue to renew my mind day to day to day. And it allows my body to be able to adjust in order to do the things that I wanted to do. So anyway, you guys, I'm thirsty as all get out. I'm kind of dehydrated. I can hear it in my voice, actually. Because I went for a long run this morning and then a long walk. So, which turned into a run and then a walk again. So anyway, I'm going to get off here so I can go get some water. I love you guys as always. I will keep praying for you. You keep praying for me. Y'all keep praying for me, okay? Mm-hmm. So anyway, I'll talk to y'all
this
later.
For every
peace
one
out, baby.
Of you out there. Mwah. Have patience. Wait on the Lord. Just grab your neighbor by the hand and tell him, wait on the Lord. Tell him, wait on the Lord. Tell him, wait on the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The song simply says this. Sometimes in life, you'll find that you get in a hurry. But when you have assurance, no need to worry. You can wait on the Lord, and you'll see He'll always keep His word. But you must just trust in Him. Don't be dismayed. Whoa, can cause say
patience in time of trouble.
Yeah.
Trust and